Adjust my mic here. Alright, welcome to WWE 2K19 Universe Mode. Here with the very first episode, Bound for Glory, here in Long Island, New York.
The grandeur, the magnificence of our business is on full display tonight.
Alright, well, first match of the night is for the X Division Championship.
Hey, it's pretty cool seeing TJP here compared to one.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, and it's for the championship. Introducing the challenger from Los Angeles, weighing in at 175 pounds, TJP.
You strike me as the kind of guy who dabs a lot. From time to time. Yeah, you know,
so I'm going to do something a little different in this universe mode. Basically, I'm going to pretend like I'm part of the commentary team if I can. I'll probably just do it for this episode, see how it goes, see how I actually like it.
Alright, I begrudgingly admit you're right on that. The premier athlete has arrived.
Yeah, and here he is, Tony Nese.
You might need to take your shoes off.
Come over here. Come here, I want to tell you something. This right here, this is why I'm the premier athlete. And let me show you something else. Let's count it out together. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That's 8 reasons why I'm the premier athlete. 8 reasons why I'm better than each and every one of you.
And introducing the
obviously talking about is, I guess, 8-pack ab.
So, serious question
the
here.
Athlete, Tony.
How many grams of protein do you think Tony Nese consumes every day?
I don't know, Zach. You should probably ask Tony Nese, but I know you're not important enough for him to acknowledge your existence. My sources tell me that in some states, they're trying to pass a law. It's going to be illegal for Tony Nese to wear a shirt in public.
Oh, stop it.
Are you serious? I am too.
Debuted at 16 years old.
And introducing the challenger from Guadalajara, Jalisco, Mexico, weighing in at 175 pounds, Grand Metalik.
All right, side note, I may have to adjust the volume for different things for the next episode.
Grand Metalik, otherwise known as the King of the Ropes, one of the most exciting superstars in the Cruiserweight division.
Because looking at the recording, it looks like the in-game sound is like really loud. I don't know. There he is, the new and improved Inferno. And the current X Division champion.
And introducing the
champion from the other side of darkness, weighing in at 135 pounds.
Sounds to me, guys, like this crowd is ready to get this night started.
They're not the only ones, Cole.
It seems to me that these superstars want nothing more than to get their hands on one another.
So, one thing I hate is that they talk over the announcement of who this is. I mean, I guess it's all right. I gotta say, the lighting looks really good in this.
To this type of match, which makes it so interesting, is that it can lead to the formation of unlikely alliances. Just another thing to have to worry about when you're competing against three other superstars all at the same time.
Yeah, but these competitors will have their hands full, Cole. In a fatal four-way, you have to have your head on the swivel at all times.
Absolutely.
German suplex!
And the roll up on the outside, but...
And the champ kicks out.
Yeah, this is
that doesn't count.
To be going for the win.
He's just playing classic offense here. He's got him.
This. Yeah, I kind of knew that already.
Cover. And Grand Metalik quickly kicks out.
Nice kick out there.
Going for the stretch here. Take over. Now that's the type of move that sends a message to an opponent.
I don't know. I feel like... Oh my gosh. I feel like the lighting is a little too bright. And why was TJP moonwalking backwards?
I don't know, Michael, but good thing. I don't think he could have taken much more of that.
Oh, what a snap there. Perfectly executed.
And the referee has been taken out.
Oh, I think this band
seems all right now.
Here's a cover. He stops the count. Corey, I think you're just trying to drum up controversy. I haven't heard any whispers about the champion having to defend against inferior competition.
Yeah, inferior competition? That's nuts. I'm willing to bet the champ started that rumor in an attempt to get into his opposition's head. Either that, or Corey's just making stuff up, as you alluded to, Michael.
This is what makes him one of the best in the business. Gets out of the way of that one. Knocked him right off his feet.
Yeah, no kidding. Looking for an open.
Grand Metalik, that's gotta be it.
Oh, the crowd's on the edge of their seats.
Now a pinfall attempt.
And there's the kick out. Not yet. This is not where you want to be. He's inflicting some serious pain here. The champ with reason to be concerned.
Anytime a superstar sees an opening for their finisher, they got to take it, as Byron was saying. Elongating the match not only gives your opponent an opportunity to get back in it, but you're also running the risk of injury anytime you're in the ring longer than you have to be.
Yeah, but sometimes you just enjoy beating somebody up, especially if you're in the ring with somebody like Saxton.
There he goes, crashing to the floor.
Why are we always picking on Saxton?
Nicely executed. Nobody controls the pace of a match quite like this guy. When this guy's on, look out. Seems to me, guys, like we're just moments away from seeing the finisher, which could obviously put this match on ice. Bang, right to the face. The challenger's championship dreams are fading quickly. I don't recall the last time he looked so fatigued.
And you get the feeling that he's not going to look back at this match with great fondness.
Nice wants to put this away. He's going for the pin. And another one. And a kick out, much to nobody's surprise.
TJP refusing the P-I-N there. See what I did?
Shoulders on the mat. And TJP with a quick kick out.
TJP refusing the P-I-N there. See what I did?
It's going to take a lot more than that to keep him down.
Oh, wow. You got to think about using the finisher here pretty soon, I would think. Just pick up the win and move on. There's no need to keep this thing going longer than necessary.
He caught him slipping. The champ is in a bad way here. The pressure of competing in this fatal four-way match may have finally gotten to him. He is hurt.
He's fading fast here, guys. If I'm his opponent, I'm thinking about putting him out of the chicken wing gut buster. Oh, man, the champ looks absolutely out of it right now.
You get dropped like that, you don't get up, period. Good point by Byron earlier. If there's an opening to execute the finisher, you got to take it. The last thing you want to do is let your opponent hang around for no reason. I can tell you, bad things happen when you do that. If you don't believe me, just go back and watch Skip versus Barry Horowitz from 1995.
I remember that like it was yesterday, Cole. Instead of putting Horowitz away,
he looks for it once again. And he delivers a brutal DDT.
Gotta like the champ's chances now.
Oh boy, he is whoa.
Showing some quickness there.
TJP's in trouble.
So damaging.
TJP is not gonna like this.
And Grand Menelik slips out of harm's way. He'll be feeling the effects of that for a while.
Continuing to attack Inferno.
Loves to fly.
Now it's time to capitalize.
That would land it, that's for sure. Big time takedown right there.
This might just be it for him, Michael.
Simply will not.
Oh, what a DDT! Wow.
But I don't know how much gas he has left, guys. Hey, what goes up must come down.
Ooh, right into that ring post.
Perfectly executed. Well, I think this man means business. He's really putting his athleticism on display here. From what we've seen and heard tonight, there must be serious injuries.
Will it be?
I think so!
And TJP with a quick kick out.
Too soon.
Showing off his vertical with that drop kick.
Oh boy, he is rolling. Oh boy, he is rolling.
Why did you repeat yourself?
He's making a statement here with this attack. That's got to hurt the arm. Escapes trouble there. Here he goes. It's all academic from here.
This is his opportunity to win this thing.
Shoulders down. Two. Three.
And Inferno retains.
In the fatal four-way. That was a match for the ages. Fatal four-ways always deliver the goods, but you can only see matches like that once in a decade or so.
That was just one of those matches that the men involved should just be proud to be a part of. A legendary performance. This entire match was just one big highlight reel, and I didn't expect anything else.
Here is your winner, and still, Impact Cruiserweight Champion, NRO.
Kicking off the night with an impressive victory.
Yeah, the performance put forth in that match tells me we're looking at somebody who will someday, very soon, be competing in the main event.
Believe it or not, that's just the beginning, folks. Stay tuned for more great action.
Yeah, and speaking of more action, up next, Eli Drake issues an open challenge for anyone. We'll have to see who answers his challenge up next. I'm not sure who this is.
And his opponent from Green Bay, Wisconsin, weighing in at 251 pounds, Mr. Kennedy.
All right, why is this music playing? And also, I forgot to change his name. Oh, well.
It's time for our first match of the night, guys, and it looks like we have quite the contest coming up. And good luck to those who have to follow this one. You're going to need it.
Well, Mr. Kennedy, Mr. Anderson, whoever you want to call him, he's here, and he's answering Eli Drake's open challenge.
These competitors will have their hands full, Cole. In a fatal four-way, you have to have your head on the swivel at all times.
Fatal four-way? What?
Like this is exactly how a competitor takes control of a match. Nice move. He's not in a good spot here, guys. He simply needs to find
right over the top rope there.
That'll have you worrying about long-term injuries for sure. Looks a bit off his game here. He's gonna have to be careful. Three guys he's in there with want this match just as much as he does. Yeah, but if you count him out now, guys, you'd be making a very big mistake. Mark my words.
Let's call it like it is, guys. It doesn't get much bigger than this. A featured match on a major WWE pay-per-view. This is huge for these superstars.
Now in for the pin.
And a kick out, much to nobody's surprise.
I don't think his opponent was expecting that.
Yeah, what is up with the lighting in this arena? I mean, I did download this from Community Creations. But, yeah, the lighting is like way too bright.
We all know, though, this guy has plenty of fight left in him.
A crucial point in the match here, guys. He's got a target on his back now, and I wouldn't be surprised to see a 3-on-1 attack here.
The good news for him is that he doesn't appear to have taken too much offense up to this point. But this might be it.
Oh, my. I'm not sure how much he has left.
Did they use some, like, the glow effect on the ring ropes? Because when they did, like, the close-up of the ring, it kind of looked like it.
I think we know what this is.
And a rolling senton there.
Just did? Incredible! Digging deep for a kick out.
Wow!
Very impressive by Eli Drake.
He's inflicting some serious pain here. Wow.
I don't think Eli Drake has what it takes to finish this match.
He's got the shoulders down.
On the dirty pin.
Hey, kick out. This one's not over yet.
Using the ropes for leverage.
An impressive series of moves.
Looks like no.
Gentlemen, it's time to go to school.
Woo!
Figure four leg lock.
Looks to me like he's starting to feel the pressure, guys.
Looks to me like he's on Dream Street right now, fellas. That's not a place you want to be when you're in the ring with these three guys.
Whoa! He gets out of it.
He's at another level right now, Michael.
Clothesline finds them off. Whoa, down he goes.
That was impressive, Cole.
Can he score the pin? And he kicks out.
And the match continues.
God, what a stiff shot. And right on the mark. At the elbow. Oh, my goodness, crushing it.
Oh, boy, he is rolling.
That's it. It's over. It's over.
Oh, boy, he is rolling.
No, there's the reversal. There he goes, crashing to the floor.
I swear I set Mr. Anderson's, like, entrance music so where it's, like, no music. I know I did. So that must be a bug or something.
This is what makes him one of the best in the business. Lightning fast reflexes. It's starting to look bleak for him now. Don't be surprised if he can't find a way to bounce back here in this fatal four-way match.
Oh, boy, he is rolling.
Clearly on shoulders on the mat. One, two.
He's going to kick out at two. Point.
How'd he do that?
The end may be near. Oh, I think this man needs business.
That might have done it, Cole.
He thinks he has it. One, two. Dug down deep and gets the shoulder up. Woo. Incredible. This has to be it. Would you look at this? Simply amazing.
It looks like they both did their homework heading into this one.
Oh, boy, he is rolling.
He
He might have it. One of the buses. This one's over. That should do it. This could do it.
Uh-oh.
Two. Barely at 2.5.
I'm impressed.
How much more will they... Are they willing to go?
Here we go.
Yeah, see, right there, it looks like... The glow effect on the ropes.
He goes for the cover. Two. You can't teach the type of
thing. Oh my gosh, how long is this match gonna go on for?
He needs to change something fast, guys. Here he goes for the win and an earfall.
Wow, I am impressed.
Gets him with a knee there. When this guy's on, look out. The human body can only absorb so much of that. Quick thinking to avoid that one. That's how you move up the ladder here in WWE. He wants it one more time. This is a level of destruction no one was expecting.
Big clothesline there.
That should do it right there. Two.
And Eli Drake with the win. It wasn't even a fatal four-way.
Some incredible action from a match that we're not likely to stop talking about for a long, long time.
That was just one of those matches that the men involved should just be proud to be a part of. A legendary performance.
Here is your winner, Eli Drake.
And the first match of the night comes to an end in thrilling fashion.
And you just know the rest of the card is watching in the back, wondering how in the world they're going to follow that.
Plenty more action still to come here tonight, folks.
All right, well, up next, a bit of a rematch from the last episode of Impact Wrestling on 2K18 Universe Mode. We saw Sami Callihan as well as OVE versus the Dream Team. That would be Velveteen Dream and Tiger Jackson and Eddie Edwards teaming up with them. And the Dream Team and Eddie Edwards won that match. So next up, Sami Callihan is going up against Velveteen Dream and a bit of a rematch from that match. Yep, Velveteen Dream.
And his opponent, from Capitol Hill, Washington, D.C., weighing in at 227 pounds, Velveteen Dream.
intoxicating, mesmerizing. A megastar destined for the stratosphere in sports entertainment.
Yeah, known for his combination of ruthlessness and unbridled flamboyancy.
Anything you can do, the Velveteen Dream can do better. The real deal. This kid's got it all. WWE Universe intoxicated by the Dream. How can you not be? So charismatic.
I'm not gonna lie, it's hard for me to take my eyes off him.
It's Dream time.
What's he doing now?
Firing anything he wants. He's the Velveteen Dream.
Corey, I think he wants you to go talk to him.
Oh yeah, and I forgot to mention this is an Extreme Rules match.
Here we go, fatal four-way action is underway.
Mark my words, Cole. These four superstars are about to embark on the fight of their lives.
Drives him down with a bulldog. Quick punch. In on the face now. He's on the defensive here. He needs to make sure he doesn't get double or even triple teamed here.
And I guarantee you the other three guys see the predicament he's in and are thinking of wait.
Wow, he got out of it.
Yeah, I'm not so sure he had it fully locked in.
They get dangerous out here, especially when there are no countouts.
Now, first weapon being brought in, the steel chair.
Guys, there's something special about competing on a WWE pay-per-view event. Uh-oh, double underhook. This is going to be nasty. Butterfly pile driver.
I think this is the beginning of the end, Mike.
Going for the cover. Digging deep for a kick out. Not yet.
I'd agree with your earlier point, Michael. There's nothing like the bright lights of a WWE pay-per-view. But there's also nothing like the pressure of competing on a WWE pay-per-view. A loss here could set you back quite a bit.
Yeah, but a win, now that could be career-changing. Think about it. Picking up a win while the entire...
Look out, look out! This
and
could be it!
Sami Callihan now. Apron DDT.
Pounding DDT.
Victory is on the horizon.
We may very well be seeing the finisher here very shortly, guys, and when that happens, you can bet this one's gonna be over.
Oh, and it's a reversal.
Now fighting into the crowd.
Right in the gut. Just a painful attack on the midsection. I'm with Corey. I suspect the finisher is on the horizon, and given how impactful that move has been as of late, I'd say there's almost no coming back from it.
You're right, Michael. It seems like that finisher has become more and more impactful with each passing week. But that's even possible.
He hits him with a nasty chop. He's making a statement here with this attack. And that chop finds its target. Nobody controls the pace of a match
quite like this guy. Watching this match, I can't help but think how much pay-per-views have grown over the years. I mean, remember the ones back in the 1980s, which were great, don't get me wrong. But now, they've really grown into such a major spectacle.
He's trying to mangle his face here. Right to the face.
Looks like he's starting to tire.
This match is definitely testing his mettle, guys.
I'm really disappointed in what we're seeing from him here tonight.
Heading in,
Ryan and
I
two.
Really thought he had a chance of winning this fatal four-way match.
Barricade, I guess you could sure say.
The bottom line here is that despite what's going on right now, he's still in much more favorable health than his opponent.
Oh, what a right!
Man, that's some attitude behind it.
Reverses that one. Got him good with the elbow there. We're witnessing a level of punishment that can only be described as severe. He's making a statement here with this attack. Abuses him with an elbow. Going after the midsection. This kind of offense he's known for. Nobody controls the pace of a match quite like this guy. And he lands a hellacious uppercut. That'll leave a knot on your head. The end may be near, folks. He may very well be on Dream Street right now, guys. He has got to do something quick. You have to possess a different type of focus to punish an opponent like this.
Oh, boy, he is rolling.
He's focusing on the face now. Got it. That'll rearrange your face. What a forearm.
Still fighting into the crowd.
Breaking uppercut.
I mean, in the crowd.
Delivered. When this guy's on, look out. And there's a chop. He's trying to mangle his face here. The body can't take much more of that. Ooh, with the point of the elbow.
Oh, boy, he is rolling.
Working the gut. I think I saw some teeth fly out on that one. Ow, that hurt. Oh, he's such a tough target. Jeez. Any uppercut lands.
Working well, this is going
there.
On for a while.
He lands a jarring forearm. He's focusing on the face now. Ooh. Lights up his chest with a chop. This guy can go toe-to-toe with anybody. Oh, he turns it around.
Oh, boy, he is rolling.
Ooh! He's targeting the midsection here. There's no recovery from that. That elbow will leave you dazed. Showing some quickness there. Oh, I think this man needs business. I don't want to know what that feels like. He kicks him right in the gut. He's inflicting some serious pain here. Oh, I think this man needs business. He lands the punch. That could break a nose.
Now finding towards the stage area.
Slam down with authority. Dodges a bullet there. Drop.
Looks like both these superstars
and
have found that
looks like
extra
Sami Callihan
going
to try to win by count out.
He's bringing it back inside the ring now.
Or maybe resetting the count. I'm not sure what he's doing.
At this point, it looks like even the winner of this match will walk out of here beaten and battered.
Death Valley Bomb. That has got to be it.
Here's the cover. Two. Gets the shoulder up. Wow. What's it going to take?
It's hard to believe, but it looks like he still has some gas left in the tank.
Uh-oh, double underhook. This is going to be nasty.
Twice as nice.
That's how you put an exclamation point on a match.
He may get the three count right there. Two. What? Oh, he kicked out.
Barely a three count.
I'm just as shocked as everyone else, Cole.
He's looking at it. It's got to be hard to rebound from that one.
Can he finish him off here?
Penny predicament. Two.
And Sami Callihan looked away.
These guys were awesome. Let's take another look.
Tonight, we are in for an amazing evening.
What a way to kick off tonight. Don't go anywhere, folks. We're just getting started.
Alright, well, next up we have Alexa Bliss going up against Paige.
From the start, Paige dared to be different. Paige dared to stand out, and she has benefited from that mindset.
Guys, remember on Raw a few years ago when Paige made her WWE debut and won the Women's Championship?
A truly unforgettable.
So it seems like the voiceover or whatever is kind of off. At least for Paige. And what's this?
Here we go. And a sign of sportsmanship to start this match.
Looks like Bliss asking for respect. And
what disrespect?
Alexa Bliss disrespecting Paige.
This is it, folks. Fatal four-way action.
It's not a fatal four-way.
This is going to be one of those matches people will be talking about for a long time to come.
Look out.
Alright, so real quickly, I want to pause it just to see, like, the options of what to do or anything. So, real quick. Alright, I'm back.
That's how you make an impact. She got her good there. Oh no, she's in a bad way now. Back in from the floor.
If you ask me, guys, this match alone is worth the price of this month's WWE Network subscription. Of course, there's other great matches on this pay-per-view card, but for my money, it doesn't get any better than this.
Alexa Bliss may have it.
Insult to injury.
That creates a
nice move there by Alexa Bliss.
I think a lot of people share Corey's. Look out. Alexa Bliss is one move after the other. It's devastating. She goes for the cover.
A kick out at two.
She's still in this one. And Alexa Bliss.
Now, Alexa Bliss top rope.
He turns it around on her. Oh, this is not good at all. The much more of this, and she could be facing a torn ligament.
Just go for the finisher already. I don't understand the delay. The object is to win the match, isn't it? Come on, let's go.
Looking for all the glory here. Oh, a quick kick out by Paige.
Gonna take a whole lot more.
I don't think the referee got down there in time.
As Corey continues to criticize. Oh, Alexa Bliss may have it.
Yeah, she's getting after it. And two from the goddess with insult to injury.
That's it. That's what she needed.
She goes for the cover. Oh, somehow.
Right now, I just don't know what it's gonna take.
Now Paige getting up
to be guys like we're just moments away
catching Alexa Bliss,
which could obviously put this match on ice.
Her leg anyway.
Paige wants to put it away.
Rampage.
We may be looking at our winner here, guys.
We got a cover.
One, two, and the shoulder's up.
She's still in this one.
The finisher could absolutely end this match, Michael, as you were saying, but it's not a guarantee. Sometimes it takes two or even three to get the job done, and even then, it's not a sure bet.
Paige wants to put it away.
Here we go. Paige, look at this. Astonishing maneuver by Paige.
Wow, what a move by Paige.
Paige is rolling now.
Now taking the fight to the outside again.
And Paige manages to reverse out of that one.
This is some great offense by Alexa Bliss. You got to think about using the finisher here pretty soon, I would think. Just pick up the win and move on. There's no need to keep this thing going longer than necessary.
Exactly.
Jacks the jaw.
When looking back at this pay-per-view years from now, don't be surprised if it's this match that people are talking about most.
good point by Byron earlier. If there's an opening to execute the finisher, you got to take it. The last thing you want to do is let your opponent hang around for no reason. I can tell you, bad things happen when you do that. If you don't believe me, just go back and watch Skip versus Barry Corliss from 1990.
Alexa Bliss looks to finish this one early. Look at the look in her eyes.
And a kick out of that, too.
I thought that was it.
Yeah, and just when you think Paige is done, she fights her way back into it.
That lands. She lands an enormous elbow. She goes for the cover. One, and Alexa Bliss gets out of the pinfall. Not yet.
She is on fire.
Look at Paige making her move.
Now a rampage.
Rampage. If that doesn't end it, I don't know what will. She goes for the cover. One, two. Not enough to end this one.
Nice kick out there.
About long-term injuries for sure.
I think Alexa Bliss waiting for Paige to get up.
To me like these superstars are on their last legs here.
You can see the confidence just beaming from her right now. Well, she wants this win bad.
A great offense by Alexa Bliss.
Here comes Alexa Bliss. Alexa Bliss hits it.
This one,
this may very well be it. Oh, how resilient.
And still a kick out at two.
Superstars are doing it right now. They've got to be exhausted.
Yeah.
Paige wants to put it away.
I don't understand how they're still going.
Paige Turner.
Man, she knows how to make. We got a cover. Two. Two count and a kick out.
I'm just as shocked as everyone else, Cole.
Look at Paige here. She's in full control now. She's got her.
Oh, man, Paige is in trouble.
Paige wants
you mean
to put it
Alexa
away.
Bliss?
She's in control.
On a reversal.
Alexa Bliss gets out of the way quickly.
Yeah, she's getting after it.
She goes for the cover. One, two.
That was definitely a three count.
She kicked out there. This is some great offense by Alexa Bliss.
Look out. Alexa Bliss is measuring.
Insult to injury.
Wow. Spot her way all the way to the cover. One, two, three.
Alexa Bliss finally with the
win.
Alright, I need to figure out how to turn replays off.
Way to win a match as entertaining and action-filled as that one, they should be grateful and really
proud.
Some great stuff.
Alexa Bliss.
Big win here to start the show.
Yeah, the performance put forth in that match tells me we're looking at somebody who will someday, very soon, be competing in the main event.
Believe it or not, that's just the beginning, folks. Stay tuned for more great action.
Alright, so Alexa Bliss is definitely looks like heel. Paige is the face. Alright. Anyway, up next, tag team titles on the line in an open challenge match. The Shield versus whoever accepts the challenge. And I think I know what tag team this is. None other than Team 3D, the Dudley Boys. Over Ray Dudley and Devon Dudley, but wait. Right from the back and running into each other.
Oh, and now we have a brawl on our hands.
Oh, yeah. They didn't need the match to start to make a point.
He's inflicting some serious pain here.
Bubba Ray Dudley taking it to Roman Reigns.
Oh no! Oh, I think this man means business. His drop kick connects.
Oh yeah, here's Seth Rollins.
You have to possess a different type of focus to punish an opponent like this. Now that's how you make a statement. He's inflicting some serious pain here. Great move.
Reversal by Bubba Ray Dudley.
Takes him down.
Now the tag made to Roman Reigns.
Oh, Roman Reigns saw that one coming.
Straight to the head of Seth Rollins.
Combinations you will ever see. Seth Rollins is in position.
A curb stomp.
That might be enough.
We've got a cover.
And the Shield retained the titles.
I can't remember a tag team match in recent memory that was even close to as good as that one was.
That was just one of those matches that the men involved should just be proud to be a part of. A legendary performance.
Here are your winners, and still the Impact Wrestling World Tag Team, Seth Rollins and Roman Reigns. The Shield.
And that's a win to start off the night.
Let's not overcomplicate things. This business is simple. It's all about wins and losses. And it sure looks to me like somebody has figured that out.
What a way to kick off tonight. Don't go anywhere, folks. We're just getting started.
All right, well, up next, the Knockouts Championship on the line. Sue Young versus Rosemary.
And it's for the Impact Wrestling Women's Championship.
Yeah.
Guys, we're getting the night started with an amazing matchup here.
You're absolutely right, Cole. In fact, I don't think there's a better way to start this night than with this match right here.
Here comes Su Yung, the champion who won the Impact Knockouts Championship in her debut.
What a great match we have here to start off this night, guys.
And Michael, I had to check twice when I saw this match listed as our opener. I mean, it could very well have been our main event.
Introducing the challenger from the pits of hell, Rose Mary.
The pits of hell, huh?
Introducing the champion from your darkest fears. She is the Impact Wrestling Women's Champion, Susan Young.
Stay tuned. It's difficult to be successful in WWE in one-on-one action, but a fatal four-way? A competitor has just a 25% chance of being victorious. Those aren't the best odds for anyone.
Why do they keep talking about a fatal four-way?
Formation of alliances.
This isn't a fatal four-way. There's not four people in the ring right now.
Looking a little dazed here.
Yeah, she's definitely not looking herself right now, Cole.
Get in there, ref.
Nicely done.
The ref is in there. He's in the ring.
One move after the other. It's devastating.
We've seen champions head into matches maybe a little too confident, only to be picked off in the end. And guys, I can't help but wonder if we're going to see that again here tonight.
So far, it looks like Rosemary doing the most damage to the opponent. Su Yung.
A concerned look on the face of the champ. Fatal four-way matches are so dangerous. She's going to need to have her head on a swivel throughout this entire match.
Speaking of champions heading into matches a bit overconfident, one of the most glaring examples of that would have to be the Honky Tonk Man's attitude heading into his Intercontinental Championship event at SummerSlam 1988. We all know what happened to him on that night.
You are so right, Michael. That was great. Of course, though, it wasn't so great for the Honky Tonk Man, who ended up losing his championship to the Ultimate Warrior in fewer than 30 seconds.
Wow. Losing the championship in less than 30 seconds.
Oh, man. When she gets in attack mode, look out. Look at her get some air.
I can't believe it, Michael. You got to think about using the finisher here.
Big move coming. Wait for it.
Now Rosemary looks like Red Wedding.
Face first.
That's what she calls her finisher.
She goes for the cover. And the champ
nearly a three count.
It's going to take more than that to keep her down. Look at her go.
Yeah, Lisa, another finisher.
Good point by Byron earlier. If there's an opening to execute the finisher, you got to take it. The last thing you want to do is let your opponent hang around for no. She's looking at it. She's not playing any games tonight. Everyone better watch out.
Even me. It's heating up now.
I think this is the beginning of the end.
Wow, if that's any indication, she's not taking any prisoners in this one.
That could be it, guys. She got the shoulder up in time.
She's still in this one.
Seems to me, guys, like we're just moments away from seeing the finisher, which could obviously put this match on ice.
She drops her with a clothesline. And she got her with a clothesline.
Oh, it's over.
Oh, man, she's rolling now.
This one's getting ugly. You might want to turn away if you have a weak heart. Executed perfectly.
Shima there! That was vicious.
That right there was pretty cool. Like how Rosemary jumped and then like did that. Like,
this
no thing with her finger.
Dodges a bullet there. Whoa, it's another reversal.
I don't think I've ever seen anything. What?
Oh my God, mandible claw! Oh, gross, the mandible claw!
That's it. That's what she needed.
I think Su Yung may have just retained her championship here. Or maybe not.
At some point, the referee may want to think about stopping this one before somebody gets seriously injured.
Nobody's going to get injured.
went bad. I think she's trying to prove a point here.
The champion into the cover. Two.
How did she kick out?
Wow. I thought for sure that was it.
She's looking at it. Look at this. Looks like this one's going to go in the champ's
painful
favor.
Submission hold here. Rosemary able to get out of that somehow.
The end might just be near for her.
We're witnessing a level of punishment that can only be described as severe. Now, she just needs to finish her off.
And Rosemary, the new Knockouts champion. Show of respect between the two. Wow, that line right there was in 2K18. Alright, well up next it is our main event, a triple threat match for the Impact World Championship, Jeff Hardy versus The Miz versus Finn Balor.
Introducing the challenger from Britain, Aldislaw, Ireland, weighing in at 190 pounds, Finn Balor.
Sounds to me, guys, like this crowd is ready to get this night started.
They're not the only ones, Cole. It seems to me that these superstars want nothing more than to get their hands on one another. Go ahead, Corey. Tell us all about The Miz.
The Miz is the man who single-handedly turned SmackDown from the B-show to D-show. A star of stage, screen, reality television. Is there anything The Miz hasn't done?
Did The Miz pay you to say all that, Corey?
Absolutely not, Byron Saxton. I happen to be a hopeful for consideration for a Mizzy this year.
Really?
That's right.
Mizzy? Oh, come on.
That would be awesome, Corey.
That would be ridiculous.
Where would you put it?
On my mantle with my most prized possession.
Why are you encouraging him, Michael?
I would love to have him.
Just went through the roof in this arena. One half of Team Extreme.
The charismatic enigma about to grace the WWE Universe with his presence.
There he is, the Impact World Champion.
And introducing the champion from Cameron, North Carolina, weighing in at 225 pounds.
In every sense of the word, Jeff Hardy is immune to fear.
Synonymous with tag team title reigns, a former United States champion, former world heavyweight champion. And what's amazing to think about, guys, is that the career of Jeff Hardy started at just the young age of 16.
Alright, here we go, triple threat action.
Fatal four-way action is underway here, guys. Nicole, I can very easily see any one of these four participants winning this thing.
The Miz sitting back and letting Jeff Hardy and Finn Balor go at it.
Yeah, and you never know what will jump off up to make the highlight reel and pick up a win.
Getting his attention with a vicious strike.
Now the Miz getting some action here.
Like this is exactly how a competitor takes control of the match. Oh, I think this man means business. Look at Finn Balor here. This is some great offense by Finn Balor. He's inflicting some serious pain here.
Guys, a lot of people are predicting a new champion here tonight. Even a poll on WWE.com earlier today predicted we'd have a new champ. But at the risk of being a downer, I'll believe it when I see it.
Oh, man.
No. Roll up here.
The quick cover. Jeff Hardy quickly getting the shoulder up.
That's either sheer genius or complete stupidity, Cole.
Corey, I have to disagree with your earlier comment. I'm with the masses on this one. I think tonight is the night we crown a new champion.
Well, either way, guys, this has been one heck of a match up to this point, and I think it's only going to get better.
Well, I believe so, too. And I mean, with these triple threat matches, you don't know who's going to win.
Nice job by the Miz.
I guess that goes for every match.
Oh boy, he is rolling.
Every superstar knows that the key to being a perennial main eventer is securing a favorable spot in the weekly rankings, just like this superstar did this past week.
The Miz is looking at this.
It's like he's tapped into some unseen.
And the Miz delivers the snap DDT, and that should do it.
This is all but over. The Miz with the offense. And Finn Balor gets out of the pinfall.
Yeah, it's just too early. It's going to take more than that.
Corey's absolutely right. The weekly rankings are so very important to achieving long-term success here in the WWE.
Balor looking to end it. Oh, almost through the turnbuckle.
Incredible.
And now Finn Balor heads up.
Uh-oh, this isn't going to end well for someone.
He finally got it, guys.
Nobody controls the pace of a match quite like this guy.
Okay. Just go for the finisher already.
Clearly on a mission here.
Nice. Shut it down.
Now, face lock here.
And you have to wonder how much the chin lock can sustain at this.
Whoa, he gets out of it.
He's at another level right now, Michael.
Wow, Finn Balor is being controlled.
He has something big planned. As Corey continues to criticize the action in the ring, allow me to take the others. Looking for the quick cover is Jeff Hardy.
And Finn Balor gets out of the pinfall.
Yeah, just too early. Too soon.
Oh, man. Finn Balor is really feeling the pressure.
Jeff Hardy's looking to finish this.
Will this be enough?
He's not done fighting yet.
It'll take more than that.
He's in full control now.
Jeff Hardy makes a cover.
Seems to me, guys, like we're just moments away from seeing the finisher, which could obviously put this match on ice.
Oh, here we go. Jeff Hardy makes a cover.
And Finn Balor able to kick out right away.
He's in big trouble.
I can't tell you how many victims have suffered the same fate.
The finisher could absolutely end this match, Michael, as you were saying.
Look at Finn Balor making his move.
Look at this. Miz. Skull-crushing finale.
Skull-crushing finale. Definitely seems like it for the Miz. But Finn Balor getting up.
Cover, cover.
Breaking up the pin.
Great effort, but he better save something for later in the match.
Now that got those shoulders on the mat.
And Finn Balor gets out of the pinfall.
Yeah, just too early.
The Balor Club is willing Finn Balor to continue this fight.
A gutsy battle for sure.
It's like he's tapped into some unseen energy source.
Oh, you cannot take your eyes off him for a second.
Really?
Oh, boy, he is rolling.
Now Jeff Hardy.
You can see the wear and tear that this fight has taken out of these men.
Look out!
Diving off
on
to Miz, but Miz shoving them out of the way.
He wants no part of the outside.
Nearly driven through the mat.
The Miz is looking in this.
So and damaging.
The Miz, I think, using Jeff Hardy's own end finisher against him.
And he got a near fall out of it.
Jeff Hardy just refuses to fade away tonight.
Oh, what's it going to be?
Sickening thud as his body is driven to the mat. The shoulders are down.
Two!
And a kick out.
He can withstand a lot more punishment, I can promise you that.
And gentlemen, the Miz may be fading away here.
He started this match in great health, but now it's got the shoulders down.
The championship is in serious jeopardy, guys.
And Finn Balor might have just secured the victory.
Balor looking up.
Oh, that's it. That's got to be it. Finn Balor. Now, that's a finishing move, people.
Finn Balor never ceases to amaze me.
Finn Balor.
Now, Finn Balor in for the mitt, in for the pin.
Has his Irish up.
And it's the Miz able to stop the count. He's still in this.
Great effort, but he better save something for later in the match.
And Finn Balor slips out of harm's way.
Extraordinary elusivity.
The Irishman has his Irish up.
When this guy's on, look out.
And submission hold here. Jeff Hardy getting out of it.
Oh, out the champion into the cover. Two. This guy just refuses to quit.
It's hard to believe, but it looks like he still has some gas left in the tank. And Finn Balor slips out of harm's way.
Extraordinary elusivity.
Finn Balor is in position.
19-16.
The Miz getting outclassed here tonight, guys.
Oh, the reversal by the Miz. One, two. Oh, I can't believe he had the energy to kick out of that. Balor shooting out of that pinfall like a bullet.
Now armbar submission.
Look out, he breaks free. Great job by him there, but he's still in a tough spot, Cole.
Oh boy, he is rolling. Figure four leg lock.
Now, figure four leg lock.
New champ here.
Look, the human body can only absorb so much of that.
That's how you put an exclamation point on the end of a match, guys.
He's trying to mangle his face here. This man needs business.
The Irishman has his Irish up.
Balor looking to end it. And he's taken down with authority.
I think I felt the ground shake on that one.
And there's the reverse. Looking to end it here.
This could be it.
A kick out, and you can see the frustration starting to build.
Jeff Hardy just refuses to fade away tonight.
Look at Finn Balor here. Man, what a move. Unbelievable power. Spin kick to the midsection.
The Miz is showboating, but I'm not sure this occasion calls for it. Oh boy, he is rolling.
Jeff Hardy's on the attack. His shoulders are down. Two.
No way, a two count still.
Look at the look on his opponent's face, Cole. He can't believe it.
The Miz was able to get out of the way there. Goes down hard.
Oh, gee. Jeff Hardy went down hard, guys.
Inflicting some serious pain here.
The Irishman has his Irish up.
This is what makes him one of the best in the business. A big boot right there.
Jeff Hardy's just barely getting out of the way.
So quick. He's too quick for him there. Finn Balor. Big move coming.
Oh, 19-16. Just when you thought he had nothing left.
And it's the Miz able to stop the count. How?
How?
Jeff Hardy is in position.
Now twist of fate by Jeff Hardy.
Defend your title. Now, Jeff Hardy needs to capitalize on this opportunity.
He's going for it all. Jeff Hardy's looking
now, Swanton Bomb.
This man needs business. Wow. Look at this. Two.
Are you serious?
What's it going to take?
The Balor Club is willing Finn Balor to continue this
fight.
A gutsy battle for sure.
Look out, down he goes. And he might not get back up.
Oh, somehow he breaks it.
He may have broken free, Cole, but I assure you the damage is a skull-crushing finale.
Skull-crushing finale?
You crowned a new champ here.
Does Jeff Hardy even know where he is? If you're the
wow, he escapes it.
He's just got no quit in him here tonight, Cole.
The Miz with a nice reversal.
He got him with the kick.
The Miz connecting there with a good shot.
Oh, boy, he is rolling.
Oh, man.
Oh, and a terrific reversal by Finn Balor.
The Miz is showboating, but I'm not sure this occasion calls for it.
This is a level of destruction.
This match has gone on for way too long.
A minor. He breaks it. I can't believe it.
I can't believe I'm going to say this, but I'm with you, Cole. Solo.
God-crushing finale.
Can he finish him off here?
The Miz is looking at
the skull-crushing finale to Finn Balor, too.
Might just be the final nail in the coffin.
He could pin his opponent right here. Two.
And The Miz, the new world champion.
Incredible. The Miz is the new champion.
Well, guys, not sure what you think, but that was one of the most incredible triple threat matches I've ever had the pleasure of being a part of.
Here is your winner and new Impact Wrestling World Champion, The Miz.
Big win here to start the show.
To end the show.
I can't wait to see the rest of the card unfold. Plenty more action still to come here tonight, folks.
So, a little bit of my opinion on Universe Mode so far. Honestly, the matches are way too slow-paced. Like, even when I put momentum, like, too fast. Because I actually did that. And, yeah, the matches are way too long. So, I don't know if that's like a bug or something. Like, the momentum switching or whatever, but so far I think it's okay. Universe mode, I feel like there should be some more changes to it. Not exactly sure what, but wow, this was a long episode. So anyway, I hope you all enjoyed, and I'll see you next time for Monday Night Raw.